Good afternoon, ladies and gentlemen. Thank you for coming to today's GIC talk. I'm Susie New, a volunteer for the GIC talk. Nowadays, the weather is really hot, so it's hard for me to prepare for final exams. However, in a few weeks, summer vacation is just around the corner. Do you have any plans for this summer vacation? I think it doesn't matter how much time you have, but how you measure time. So, not very time. I'm sure that all of you will spend summer vacation wisely because you are the type of thoughtful person to attend GIC talk. Anyway, before enjoying today's GIC talk, please make sure that your cell phone has been turned off or switched to silent mode. 소지하신 핸드폰은 신동모드로 변경해 주시면 감사드리겠습니다. Today, the speaker is going to talk about art and dance as art and education. Human beings have been communicating through dance for thousands of years. Participating in movement invention and composition connects us to our roots and allows us to communicate. Through dance, music, and visual art, we can communicate ideas and relate to one another in a more meaningful level. In this lecture, participants will learn about the history of dance and will even get to move around. This talk will be given by Angie Hartley. So please give a big hand.
Hello, thank you for coming and thank you for the introduction. Can everyone hear me okay?
Yeah.
Okay. I will speak a little louder, very possible. I'm here to talk about dance because I'm worried about the state of dance. I'm worried about how people see dance. A lot of times you might go to a dance and think, okay, that's really not for me. And I think that's a problem. And I want to try to correct this problem for a few reasons. One is that we can all dance. It's part of our history as human beings. And I want people to recognize that and feel confident that you can return to that. And also because as people who don't share a native language, I think art and dance allow us to communicate together about something that is really hard to speak or write about, especially for us. So, before we start, I want to ask you if you have an idea about what is dance. If you looked up dance in the dictionary right now, what do you think it might say? Yes?
Moving to show expression or emotion.
I think the dance is all body movement, following the musical rhythm.
Okay.
Not only legs or arms, sometimes not even face or neck. So I say all body movements follow, you know, the musical rhythm.
Okay. Following music, connected to or following? Well, okay, thank you. So I searched for dance in the dictionary, and it's really kind of a very large, vague term. So there are many definitions in the dictionary. The first one is to move one's feet or body or both rhythmically in a pattern of steps, especially to the accompaniment of music. So this seems like a pretty solid answer to my question, but I can argue with all of these points and also agree with all of these points. So I think there's actually more to it. For example, the concept of movement alone, yes, dance is movement, of course, that's very true. But also, stillness can be dance. Not moving can be a dance. One popular choreographer, Paul Taylor, started as a solo performer. In the 1960s, he went on stage and stood still for 5 minutes. He didn't move. And the curtain came down on him, and that was the dance. A lot of people were really upset about this. They paid $25 for a ticket, and they didn't get to see him move. He's a trained dancer, and they didn't get to see him move. But he's still one of the highest paid choreographers in America, because he was brave enough to push the boundaries. And even though people were upset, they were kind of also excited because he was changing our perception of what dance is. The third definition of dance in the dictionary is to bob up and down. So that's really kind of silly and specific, and I think we can all argue with that. Bobbing up and down isn't strictly dance or necessarily dance. Not until the ninth definition of dance did I find the word art. The art of dancing is the ninth definition. So that was surprising. Next, I want to ask you, what is art? Do you have any idea? If you looked up art in the dictionary, what do you think it would say?
This is super vague, but maybe trying to transfer some kind of sentiment from the artist to the audience.
Okay.
Through a medium.
Yeah, transfer.
Like a feeling or an idea sometimes.
Very difficult, so vague, and we often don't think about what makes something art and what makes something not art.
I think it's often limited to pictures or sculptures. So yeah, visual.
Creative work. So I brought with me a picture of The Fountain by Marcel Duchamp. This is a men's urinal from the men's bathroom. And in 1917, this artist took the urinal out of the men's room and turned it on its side. He put this on a pedestal in a museum, and he said, "This is art." And some people were very upset about that, and probably a little offended, especially in this time. But I searched for the definition of art in the dictionary, and it says, that art is the quality, production, expression, or realm according to a set of principles of what is beautiful, appealing, or of more than ordinary significance. And that last part is really important to me. I think because Duchamp put this urinal in a museum on a pedestal, he gave it more than ordinary significance. Its purpose is completely changed just by where he placed it and how he turned it. So by definition, this is art. He was right. So that brings us to modern dance. I think modern dance is the place where these two ideas met each other. So now modern dance means all of this. We're all right. And I think when you make a modern dance, it has more than ordinary significance. It separates itself from commercial dance, from what you see on TV, and it separates itself also from other dance forms like social dance and even ballet. So I want to sort of explain my purpose more by using the history of modern dance. I think what I really want to communicate to you is that we are all dancers and we can all create dance. It's in our potential. And that's what all of these pioneers of modern dance believe too. So they invented modern dance by believing that they were dancers and they could make something important. Isadora Duncan was one of the first modern dancers. They didn't actually call it modern dance in her time, it was called art dance. And she used musical visualization to make her movement. So if she would choose a classical piece of music and try to imitate the patterns in the music. If there was repetition, she would repeat the movement also. And she tried to capture a mood in her movement, the same mood that the composer was probably going for. Okay, I want to try an activity. We're all dancers, so I need one volunteer to do a dance. It's very simple dance, and I promise you can do it. Yes, this woman in the back, please. Okay. So she will be our medium, right? Our material, and we need one artist to also come forward. Another volunteer. Who's the choreographer or the artist? Okay. So what I want you to do is to manipulate this material, body, to express the idea of lamentation, the act of expressing grief or sadness or loss. So if you were to make a sculpture out of her, and the topic of your sculpture is lamentation, what would you do? Right. How would you chisel this
fine being?
Yeah.
Okay. Well, first I want to do two pictures, so I'm going to put in front of the light.
Great.
Perfect. And can you turn to your right? Perfect. And can you put your corner of your lips down? And your eyebrows up, and one hand just has your face. Yeah, that was that thing there.
Okay, hold your shape. Okay, and now I just want to compare it to one picture that I brought of Martha Graham.
Oh!
This is Martha Graham performing the dance Lamentation in 1930. So, do you see any similarity?
Yes, quite a lot.
Yes. The face is lifted up.
Yeah, leaning down.
Yeah.
Holding your arms up.
Yeah, very good, thank you. So, okay, you can lift now too. everyone can see the similarity. Okay, thank you very much. This was a really useful exercise for me. I think you could also use this in a foreign language classroom too. This is a great way to demonstrate understanding of vocabulary, right? Like lamentation. Maybe we can't verbalize what lamentation is. It's more complicated than just sadness. It's more complicated than just grief. But this sort of picture can help us to understand and to communicate that we share this feeling, right? Gail never met Martha Graham, but they both understood this idea really similarly. And that's really important to us as human beings, to relate to each other this way. So Martha Graham is the mother of modern dance. And they started using this term modern dance when she was making her work. She was really inspired by both classical and modern art. She used a lot of narrative in her work, so there was always some kind of story, especially during one sort of decade that she went through. She incorporated a lot of elaborate set design and costumes, and she worked with Calvin Klein to help her to design. And she also worked closely with Louis Horst, the composer. Following Graham is Merce Cunningham. He was one of her dancers. And they worked together, but he was really kind of turned off about the idea of having a narrative, having something that's abstract to inspire the dance. And he wanted to remove all of this intentional information from the dance. So he is a postmodern choreographer. The postmodern art movement is when we remove all objective effort from our work to explain reality. So it's concrete, it's not abstract. So the way he would do this is, for example, by using chant. He would make a dance in small parts, small phrases, and then he would arrange the parts of the dance by rolling a die. So here's part one, here's part two, and which one should come first and which one should follow was determined by rolling a die. So this helped him to remove any intentional theme to his work. He worked really closely with a composer named John Cage. Does anyone know John Cage? So he's an abstract composer, and even though they would show their work together on stage at the same time, they never created together. They worked separately, and on the first night of the performance was the first time they used dance and music together. And in this piece, Rainforest, he's silver clouds, helium-filled balloons made by Andy Warhol. And even the way that these balloons moved in space seemed to be due to chance. Perhaps someone in the theater opened a door during the performance. So this would change the way that the balloons moved in space. It wasn't choreographed, it's impossible. So the dancers had to react to this. And it was a little bit like improvisation, but influenced by chance. Then Marie Chouinard came a lot later. She's the queen of avant-garde performance art. So literally, avant-garde is the guard that goes in front of the other people in the military, like a scout. And Marie Chouinard was a scout in performance art, because she did some things that really pushed the boundaries of what we can call dance or what we can call art. For example, in one of her early solos, she urinated on stage. And it caused a lot of negative reactions in her community. She was kicked out of the Art Alliance in Canada, where she's from. But at the same time, this really helped us, like, very similarly to Duchamp's urinal, helped us to ask ourselves exactly what is art, what is death. And the last company I want to talk about is Palabola's Dance Theater. If this company was an art form, I would say pop art. It's a lot more accessible than other forms of dance that came out of this genre. It started with a group of four men who had never danced before. They took a class in university, and their teacher saw that because they weren't trained dancers, they were a lot more inventive and creative with the movement. So she decided to take them under her wing, and instead of using traditional dance technique, they used physical strength and principles of physics to make some really new, inventive kind of movement. If you see this company, you'll probably see them in a sold-out, giant proscenium space. And you'll notice that what they do, the physical activity, is really difficult to believe. Some of the things that they do are really impressive. But the themes that they use are very accessible and universal, easy to understand. Okay, so I'd like to try an activity with you now. If you're comfortable, you can close your eyes. I'm going to play a song, and later I will ask you some questions about how the song made you feel. Try to picture a dance while you're hearing the song, and think about who is dancing and why are they dancing? What do they look like? Okay.
So baby, let me be.
fell asleep. Very soothing music. So hopefully you have a small paper and a pen to write with. And I'm just going to ask you some questions. You don't need to write the answers down. If you'd rather just keep them in your memory, you can. And this is not the university entrance exam, so it's okay if you feel like you can't answer the question or skip one, that's fine. Don't get too concerned. If you have a question for me, if you need clarification, please ask me. So the first question is, how many dancers did you picture on stage? How many people are in this dance? And on a related note, where are they in space? Are they near the audience or far away? Are they in the center or to the left or right?
But
again, so they move around? So yeah, you can. That can be
your answer.
And they can be all. Okay. They move around through all of the space. Okay. Or maybe they only use one side of the space for some reason. Next, are the dancers characters? Like, are they sisters? Or are they in a romantic relationship? Who are these characters? And what is their relationship to each other? Maybe they aren't people at all. Maybe they are boats in water. Or maybe they are leaves in a breeze. So who or what are they? And how do they work together? Are they doing the same thing? Share their answers. You don't have to. We can move on. It's very scary. Okay. I want to encourage you all to make this a dance someday. Maybe you'll make a painting or maybe you'll make a poem. So if that's great, I want to encourage you all to make something out of this someday. So please keep your answers. Next, I want to show you a dance that I made using this song. And look for similarities between my dance and yours.
Mm-hmm.
Experience or has zero experience.
hopefully I'll be able to make everybody feel comfortable. And like I said before, some of the great pioneers of dance weren't trained dancers. So I think that you all have that same potential, because we're human beings. And there's more information about this on GuangzhouTheater.com and also on the GIC website. And there's another opportunity for performance art. Your work on stage. The Guangzhou Performance Project is hosting a script writing competition. So if you'd like to write a script, you can submit it to them by August 1st. And we'll also be hosting some writing workshops here at the GIC leading up to this project. So that concludes my workshop, and I will do the Q&A.